nice, everybody. I tell you, you hear that song, and you can't feel, you cannot feel happy. You have to feel happy when you hear that song.
It's a happy song, Joe.
It is a happy song. I got to tell you, I'm a big fan of yours, and playing your hits has just been a thrill for me because they've been such huge hits when you perform them. You start at the age of seven down there in Louisiana.
7 years old when I first started playing piano, yeah.
That's amazing. 7 years old. And then you're
27 when I recorded that.
We recorded that.
That was 1,000 years ago.
That was it. But you don't know it. Listen, and the band and I were talking about before that, if we all look as good as you at your age, we're doing pretty damn good. But what keeps you young is, you have your first, what was it like to have your first million seller?
Lord of Miss Claudie.
Lord of Miss Claudie. That had to be such a thrill for you to get started into that.
You know what, I was 17 years old, didn't know anything about records, but it was, they now have an argument about which was the first record to sell a million. Was it Impossible by Perry Como or Lord of Miss Claudie? 5 years before that,
yeah,
it was Lord of Miss Claude.
Of course it was.
First million selling record in America.
A million, it doesn't, now it doesn't seem like, but that's a huge amount back then.
And then
you're touring at a very young, you got a million sellers, so of course they're going to put you on the road. You meet DJs like Alan Freed, who was the original rock
that's
and roll
right.
DJ.
That's right.
And that had to be, what was touring like? You ran into so many legends.
You know what, I was, let me just give you an example. There was no Michael Jackson, no Beatles, there was no Rolling Stones, no Fats Domino, no Little Richard. There was only one, Lloyd Price.
That's right. King of the 50s, baby. King of the 50s.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And I always admired you because you knew guys like Frank Sinatra, and you actually, some of them, Little Richard, they actually took influence from you.
That's right. In fact, I had Little Richard recorded on his first record. I had got drafted in the Army, and in Tokyo, I called my record company. They didn't have anything on me to put out. So I told them about this little wild man I had met in Macon, Georgia, who was Little Richard. So they got Little Richard, flew to New Orleans, and recorded Little Richard. And it was amazing.
And when you came back from the service, you got right back in the groove, but it took you a little while because...
Yeah, because everybody was doing my music.
Yeah.
So I had to change around, and I heard an opera. Carol Domain, and I stole the melody just because you left it and got back in it, and right after that, Stagger Lee and 11 more in a row.
Stagger Lee is one of my all-time favorite songs, but isn't it true, like, when you went to perform that, Dick Clark asked you kind of tune it down because it's a violent song, it's a story about a pimp in St. Louis that gets murdered, but it's a great song.
Yeah,
and you put it to that, but it's your version. There was a lot of versions done with that.
That's right. They was calling it Shackley, Archibald.
Right.
Guy from, I think he was from New Orleans. But when I was in the Army, I was in special service, and I was trying to get out of the Army. Because, back then, I was in career. I was doing special service for the field grade officers and the enlisted men. I was in the hospital trying to get out. I was lying, saying I was sick and stuff. So I said, the night was clear and the moon was yellow. I was looking through a window in Korea, in Seoul, Korea.
That was it?
Yeah. And, wow. And instead of calling it Shackley, I called it Staggerly.
That is great.
And what's more, that was the B-side. I had written a song I thought would be the greatest side in the world, a song called You Need Love. Did one take with Staggerly and just threw it away.
That was one take.
That was one take. 5 million records later.
5 million.
Yeah.
You got a book out, The True King of the 50s, The Lloyd Price Story.
Yeah.
And we'd hold a copy, but we forgot to have it here. So here's Lloyd Price's book, and you can get it online. And listen, can you sing another song?
You know what? I was singing in that key. It's really high, but we're going to do it anyway.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Lloyd Price.
Thank you.